techno update. Subscribe now. Huawei MediaPad M58.4, hands-on. Features and design. There's an all-new design for the M5, and it no longer looks like an scaled-up Huawei Mate smartphone. Gone is the stripe at the top of the rear, replaced by an antenna line which hugs the edges. The lozenge-shaped fingerprint scanner stays below the screen on the front, though. It comes in two colors, champagne gold and space gray, and brings everything up to date by replacing the microSIM port with a reversible USB-C port. Unfortunately, as with many recent phones, the MediaPad M5 ditches the traditional headphone jack and bundles an adapter in the box so you don't have to use USB-C headphones. It isn't a deal breaker, but adapters are annoying, especially when you lose them or leave them behind. Cameras have been updated, so there's now a 13MP sensor at the rear end, as before, 8MP at the front. Conditions were much too dim in the hands-on session to assess whether they're any good, so we'll reserve judgment until we can take the tablet out in the real world. The screen retains the 2560 by 1600 resolution of its predecessor, which means it also has the same 359 pixel density. It's a 16:10 aspect ratio, which is handy for watching video. It's taller and thinner than the 3:2 aspect ratio you'll find on any iPad. Hardware. As before, there's a nano SIM slot for LTE so you can pop in a data SIM and get online when out of Wi-Fi range. However, that's only on the SHTAL09 model. There's a Wi-Fi only version, model SHTW09, and it's unclear which regions will get which version. What we do know is that the tablet will come in 32, 64 and 128GB versions, and all have a generous 4GB of RAM. They also have a microSD slot for adding up to 256GB of extra storage. Aside from the design, the main upgrades are the cameras and the Kirin 960 processor. The M3 had the 950, and the 960 is the chip used first in the Huawei P10 phone. When asked why it didn't use the more recent 970 from the Mate 10 Pro, Huawei essentially said that would have been overkill. It's likely true, too. Android Oreo felt responsive when we tried various apps and there were no noticeable delays launching or switching between apps. You don't get the artificial intelligence of the 970, but the 960 does have machine learning. Combined with Huawei's MU 8.0 software, you can expect the MediaPad M5 to stay fast even when lots of apps are installed. That's certainly the case with the company's phones. MU does a great job of optimizing RAM use and also has plenty of power-saving tricks. You'll get, according to Huawei, 11 hours of HD video playback from the tablet, and it takes under 2 hours to fully charge from completely empty.